So the first step towards self-realization and enlightenment, because meditation is a technique towards self-realization. Self-realization is needed to become enlightened. And enlightenment only means that you live your life in harmony, happily, joyously. And there are two types of happiness and joy on the planet. So one type of happiness, which everyone, the pursuit of happiness is part of the constitution in North America. And there's so much amount of unhappiness because the American forefathers wrote pursuit of happiness in the constitution. It is recognized as a basic need. But no one can show you. No one can show you the way to be happy. And one person has put up a question about their close friend. And happiness, in looking for happiness, most people may become, they may take alcohol, and then everyone on the planet, or the person who has asked me this, everyone on this planet, including me, is bipolar. I'm so sorry. Everyone is bipolar, dear. Everyone. It is just about a degree. Do not you or me or someone has these swing moods because I'm sitting in front of you during a meditation and the acting of guru is making me like, you know, because it's not only an act, it is flowing through me. So at other times, I may be even more bipolar, and there is never a time that I do not really drink or smoke, but it doesn't mean that if I'm social in a social place, I won't. And I do not know the things which bad things judged by the society, which I wouldn't be. But I do not have, look at me, I'm a odd looking Indian. How many temptations do you think out there are in the world there for me? Not many. So, because my temptations are less, I have said yes to less number of things. That does not make me an authority on being good or bad. But during a time of meditation, when the intent is to be one with God, we become pure. So the answer to the person who has asked is that the person who is using alcohol and becoming bipolar, etc., everyone is bipolar. The root cause of alcoholism is looking for happiness from the 13th year of that person's life. And then at 17 and a half, there is a lot of anger. And at 24th, there is a cheating, some sort of a cheating is there in that person's life. And after that, there is also bad company. So there are two or three factors, but if the person wants to be healed, then that person can contact me directly and I can pray for the person. Or you can pray for the person. You can pray for the person and I'll send you an email. But basically it is just saying mantra, endless mantras. Because that is what my life taught me. My very close family member had issues similar. And I had nothing to offer except to start praying for the person. And then after 6 months, it changed. And that's when other people started to ask me to pray for them. So since you have seen something which is affecting your friend and it's a close person, in reality, everyone on the planet is close. Just because we are on a different part of the room or even in a different time zone or even in different time, we are one. The whole of humanity is one. It's like a plant with many, many leaves, and we could start thinking I'm only this plant and I'll just take care of this myself. and of the other leaf, which you see is having issues, etc. It's that person's life. It's not really connected to me. It's my life. Then that is not enlightenment. And the people who are saying it's my life, it's my this, it's my, they are not happy. Never. The moment it comes my happiness, it means that you have an adrenal flow from something that you are presuming is good, and it could turn. You could be enjoying parachute jumping and saying, "Oh my God, I'm having such an adventurous life," and you're swinging down, you're like a bird, and then suddenly you realize that your parachute is not opening, and it changes. The same thing that was giving you joy 3 seconds ago is now a source of terror. So things keep on changing. It's our perception. So the person that you want to help, each one of us can pray for that person right now. And any prayer of any religion that you believe in will work. All prayers are to the same godliness inside each one of us, and that godliness we share. So even though we look at our body and we say, my heart is my heart and my energy is my energy, deep inside there is a common ground. Call it the deepest part of the universe, your heart energy. That's where a lot of scriptures would quote the deepest part of the heart, or it could be the heart of the creator, God, or it could be, you could be believing in a manifestation of God, Shiva, Ram, Avatar. Basically, these are all gods that we have created, Mr. Jesus, Mr. Shiva, Mr. Buddha, Mr. Muhammad. We have personified God so that our puny brains can manage it. And then we give to the God a personality, and then that personality gets a story. So we give to the God a body, and the God body is, let's say, of Christ. Then we create stories around that this body had a bad day, and it got it was like betrayed, and then there was a cross, and it was, but the soul level, the story of Jesus is about not caring about death at all. What did he care? He was a revolutionary. He went to a temple, and the people that he threw out were the bankers, etc. And he was aware of the dangers, but he still kissed the person who betrayed him, etc. And he asked for forgiveness. So he went to the cross knowing that death is not such a big thing, because this death is of the body. But in today's world, we are facing huge paradoxes. The biggest one of the biggest paradoxes is that when we have so much amount of triggers and things that should have been making us happy, we are one of the most unhappiest people. And that unhappiness, we think that money would solve it, but the amount of consumption of alcohol, of drugs, and the more richer the places, for example, Vancouver is such a beautiful place, and it has got a lot of money laundering, but rich people, and most of the rich people will be having money through somewhat dubious means. If you pay all the taxes in Canada, there's no way you're going to be rich, but you're going to feel rich. That's another story. So the amount of drugs, etc., in these places where there is dirty money, and people got dirty money because they did not want the money. Who cares for money? People thought that money would give them happiness. It does not. And then they feel defeated. And then they start buying drugs, alcohol, etc. And the other side effect that happens when we are unhappy is we start feeling a sense of entitlement. If you are poor and in India, how are you going to be feeling entitled? Probably you're just surviving. A lot of people are in a survival mode. So your mind does not let you have this luxury of having this feeling, I must be happy. Why? Why? What makes you think that you should be happy? There's no way. There's no reason. what is the big thing that you have done on this planet that you should be happy? This world is right now going through a lot of tragedy. People have lost jobs. People have lost means of income. People have lost loved ones in thousands. Why do you think that you are going to be happy? Are you disconnected from the reality that the world is suffering from? So you cannot. You cannot. We are all connected. We are all on the same planet. There is no way that someone could be happy or unhappy without us feeling a part of it. But what the teachings tell us is that we are not going to be happy. Buddha said, I'm not a Buddhist, just so that you know. I learned with the Buddhist, but I may look like a Buddhist, but I'm not a Buddhist. But he was absolutely right. Sarvam dukham. There is a lot of pain all over the world. And the pain is there because we feel entitled to happiness. We feel that, oh, it's our constitution law. We should be happy, right, because we are on the planet. And it doesn't work out. Happiness is for this group of people. And I will tell you why. Happiness is for those people who say, we are going to be source of happiness for others. That is the only happiness. Everything else is just like, you know, your body has good food, which will give you more calories. You feel good. Feeling good and happy and all those things, it's not really the big deal. It's not. It's just one of those ways. Sometimes things will happen. You'll say, oh, this is exactly what I wanted. And you feel happy. And sometimes things are, no, you are enjoying something. No, it can be. No, it went overboard. You're on some park. You're enjoying Grand Canyon, and you look overboard, and there's a swing of air, and whatever you're enjoying suddenly turns the other way, and it becomes no. So it can happen. Why not? So any source of happiness can lead you down to the other. But when your intent is, I am going to be aligned with the angels on the planet, spreading love. I am going to be a source of love for everyone. Whether they acknowledge it, whether they want it, whether they don't want it, I am going to be a source of love at the level of heart starting from. And then you will discover joy. Then you will feel joy. Okay, so we are all going to be right now. I'm going to be identified the person just by a C. So each one of us, when someone reaches out to us with some issue, then that invokes in us the power to spread love and healing. And healing is basically giving of love. We fall ill when we feel that we do not have enough love or understanding. And there are, of course, going to, the body has got expiry date, so the body is going to be having issues. But there are three types of problems. The first level of problem is always going to be from the physical world. The other type of problem is going to be the world is a changing place, and in which we are, emotions are always raw, and something invokes something. Someone can take a look at, for example, duck and say, oh my God, that poor bird. And some people will look at it, oh, this duck has got liver, and that liver is foie de gras, something that the French really like. Different things invoke different emotions, causing happiness and pain as they come and go. With thoughts, our emotions get triggered. But the third level of problems is always going to be because we came to this planet to have problems and then resolve them. I can guarantee you that there is no need for anyone on the planet to go and climb a rock. But the moment that rock is called Himalaya, do you know thousands of people die? And it's a million dollar project right now. Like, you have to be really well off. But evidently lots of people have that much amount of money. They also have ennui. They want to be doing something, and they start thinking that happiness is climbing up the Himalaya. I was born in those parts of the world. When you climb Himalaya, what do you see around? First of all, you're going through a lot of dead people. Nowadays, like you helicopter to the base camp, and you're trained by people who are experts in taking you up, etc. And when you go up, your happiness is what? Some bragging, right? Now there are already 5,000 people or so who have climbed up the Himalayas. But to look from the top of the Himalayas, all you see is rocks, frozen rocks. How is that going to make us happy? Or someone will say, I am going to be to Cuba to lie down on the sun and then lie down on the sand. And that is happiness. And sometimes it will be, oh, that person, only that person can make me happy. It's all mind games, really. But we did come to this planet to have problems. So everyone, the moment we are born, we have family, and there is no one on the planet right now who does not have anger at their parents, at least at one of them. Oh, Papa, I love, Mama, I don't, or this or that, or something like that. So we have these challenges right from the birth. When we take control of a body, that has got stories attached to it, and we are already having these challenges. And our mind does not look at the challenge as a game. As a game, we start taking it too seriously. And then we start feeling unhappy. Because if you take things too seriously, even enlightened, I am going to be enlightened with all your willpower, it won't work out. It's the same thing with happiness. You guys are so serious about enlightenment, and you are listening to this lecture, and you are in this meditation. Why is it that you're already not enlightened? All the enlightenment that people are seeking, I've seen it in a $2 Lululemon bag. In fact, I think it was free. All the enlightenment, I found it on YouTube. All the things that people were never ever declared, all the symbols, all the secret teachings, etc., including of stuff like Freemasonry, etc. All these things which are supposed to be super, super secret. You can probably find on the YouTube or on the Google some book about it or something like that. Or you can even do, if you are a cheap guy, you can, like me, you can go to wait for the COVID to go and then go to some bookstore and just sit to all these heavy books. They just have got 3 lines of meaning onto it, but they write book, big books, because that's it. So the point is, it's all in the mind. Till that time we are looking for happiness, we are going to be unhappy. Right now, one of the group has raised an issue. So we are all going to be just closing our eyes, and not as people, because what is people? People are souls with bodies. Bodies have got a name. Name has got a form, going back to the body. So your name and form is your identification. And as that identified name and body, we are very, very limited. You are someplace, somewhere, just listening, and we are just communicating through digital means. But when we close our eyes, we negate our name and body, and we go deep inside ourselves. I want each one of us, you, to go to that part of you which has the power to bless the person who is asking for help right now. And it will work. We are all magicians. We just do not know it. Closing eyes. The intent is of spreading happiness, joy, by healing the person who has her, the person's name is C, and she has a lot of stress for the last even 15 months, and a lot of unsurety, but she has to be knowing that she is supported, and we are all sending to her. This dance of healing means that she is accepting from the whole group love flowing from our hearts. And how does love flow? It doesn't flow when we are thinking, my name is this and I have this form. Focus in the center of your heart and see the symbols of energy. the spiral of infinity with Om Namo Shiva. Whatever your consciousness focuses on, that's the shape your energy, pranic energy, the life force takes. The life force is just around 24 grams, something which has been measured by the obsessed scientist. Go to this 24 grams of energy in the deepest part of your heart, and by focusing on the symbol of energy, it will become that energy. So negate out your name, negate out your body, go to the deepest part of, just focus and see the spiral of it. And with that, the magic words, Om Namo Shiva. It could be any prayer in any language on the planet. Om Namo Shiva. Amen. Allah Adonai. Allah Adonai. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. We are sending it to the Lady C. All the healing love from the whole group, past, present, and future, unite us. Past, present, and future are all combined in this 1 second. Meditation means that you focus on right now. When we focus on right now, in the deepest part of our heart, we uncover our ability to spread love and bless. Bless, bless, bless. This whole flow of energy, this whole flow of things, events, people, everything that is on the planet, in the whole creation, is just a game of energy. But when we see it with our biological eyes, we see biological things, things which have a name and form. Right now, your true intuition is opening your heart, and you see with your heart the whole of universe as a pure energy of love. There's no good, there's no bad. It's only a game of love for which we came to this planet, to spread love. And by, with your intention and focusing on the symbol of the spiral, and now the cross of Jesus, now the same cross of Jesus becomes Al-Giza, the tree of life. And then it becomes Om, and then it becomes Allah, and then it becomes Star of David. It's all fluxing. Energy is not stagnant. It does not stick at one point. It is everything and nothing. You are getting in touch with what the Kabbalah call Ein Sof. Ein Sof and Shiva are exactly same. Ein Sof of Kabbalists and Shiva of the Hindus is exactly the same. It is infinity of love. Om Namo Shiva. As heavenly beings with these bodies and with these lives and with these names, you send love right now to Lady C. And because her heart has asked for this healing magic to be happening, her heart is receiving this energy of clarity, that she is very blessed at all three levels, spiritually, materially, and emotionally. Very, very blessed person. And she's letting the whole group, she's elevating the whole group by accepting the love that she had ordered in the universe to be flowing from each one of us. And as love flows from our heart, Om Namo Shiva, we become focused on this very second. There is no definition for time. Past, present, and future, no one can explain what time is. In a meditation of deep heart blessing others, we become joined by one time we become joined by the distance. Distance is not something that separates us. Because we are on the same planet, we are in the same creation. Because we are in the same creation, we are joined by time. Because we are joined by time, we are one with the ability to spread love. Just like from your heart, you can send love to your hand or to your head. Similarly, right now you're sending love to C and all her last 18 months of stress are being removed. Her desire to be awakened so that she's fully joyous of life is awakened. To be joyous, all each one of us has to do is to be focused on now. The past has got all the anger. All the anger is from memories of things that have happened in the past. So when you focus on the now, your past falls, all your past things, that this had happened, that happened, all those things passed. So all your anger is automatically gone. Each one of you right now has a golden shining kidney. The kidney where all your fears were located are released. See your kidneys as shining bright. And see your kidneys also getting cleaned up at an energy level. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. As the past angers are released, there is no block now at a lower level. At a level of kidneys, at a lower level, you're blocked that I have this anger. Why did this happen? Why did this not happen? That had created a block which has been removed, and now your lower energy, inclusive of sexual energy, is rising. Oh, going to your heart and opening. Whatever energy connects with, it opens it. And your heart is opening like a blossom. Like a lotus, it is opening, unfolding. The heart is unfolding. When there are fears in your thinking, and all fears are based on the future, that this will happen, that will. Your anger is based on whatever had happened in the past. That is really. Now we are working by focusing on now in the things that you think can go wrong. This can happen. The partner can go away. The partner can come in. The partner can get drunk. This can happen. That can happen. All the things. Something will happen. Something will always happen. And as it is, we will be leaving this body. Not a big deal. But the main point is, whatever we have on this planet time, we spend it in spreading love. Then only we can be happy. If we are not spreading love in first in our thoughts, then our actions, and then finally, the only rich people are the people who have a legacy of acts of love. So right now, we are participating in an act of love by spreading for the deepest part of our heart, the one which is the same, which connects us to everyone. We usually open our eyes and we think we are this. I have a name, I have a body. We see only biological things. But right now, with the eyes of the heart, we see everything and everyone connected to us and inside us, while we are also inside the heart of everyone. So we focus via meditation on right now. And now we have no past. Time is gone. We only have now. We are forever in a cocoon of now. And with the past, all the anger that these things have happened are released. And with the now we work with the future. There is no future. There is always going to be a now. So let go of that imagination. And your future, for all of us, is once more going to become spiritual angels. So we will become that. So knowing that, let your fears of the past be released by focusing on right now. Om, let go of the past. Namo, be present in the now. Shivai, your future is to be one with Ain Sof. Shiva. with infinity of love. With that knowledge that we are all part of the infinity of love, no matter what it looks like, that releases all your fears of the future, so that your mind, which had these thoughts, this can, these fears and these things, these panic attacks, they were all because you were not feeling gratitude for the things which are happening in your life, which can happen in your life. You had past anger, you were holding on to the past. Regarding the future, you had fears, this can go. All those things are gone, and right now you're psychologically, the only way to become psychologically balanced is to have an open heart. When your mind have these, when your body has got anger from the past in your liver and your kidneys, your energy cannot go up, it is blocked. When in your mind you have these fears of the, you also, energy gets blocked. Your thoughts, because you are the God of the universe inside your body to some extent, 35%. You don't control your digestion. You don't even control your breathing. You have to do these things. So you are not really a true master. But you can control your thoughts and you can control your values. So we start to value our life, not as everyone else on the planet. I'm looking for happiness. This is mine. I want this. I want that, etc. You are full of gratitude with the blessing of life, this adventure that we call life. You're full of blessing and you're spreading blessing. And the more you spread blessing, the more you become aware that you are not this body, you're not this named person. You are infinity of love. Infinity of love. Om. In the deepest part of your heart, see a many-headed, a God with 1,000 faces. Brahma, the creator, has only 3 faces, but it is all meant to reflect. Have you not noticed all the gods have got 4 arms and this? They can do a lot. But the head means that millions of ways that God is present in your life. So look at, in your deepest part of your heart, see the energy as many-headed one. Many-headed one. Very, very important that you see a very many-headed goddess inside you, or God. Go beyond your body. Go beyond your mind. Go beyond your intellect. Go deep inside yourself with Om Namo Shivaya. The part which is blessing others, go deep to that part. Om Namo Shivaya. The deepest part of your heart is an ocean in which there are different waves. In these waves, you're gliding above and you can see different lives, other people's lives, your life. You're above it all. And the ocean, you know, at a deeper end is all peaceful. At the top, it's all waves which are floating, just like your life. At a deeper level, it's all totally peace. But you came to this planet for adventures of ups and downs and having this and not having that. But your meditation is giving you the tool, the energy, the superpower to be totally joyous in a soft manner, not like a drug addict. Or something wild, or just joyous that you are on this planet, that you have a body which gives you the means of serving. If you don't have a body, which after some time, whether there is COVID or we won't, how will you serve? You will become an angel and you will look for other people who are open to that. And sometimes angels are good, sometimes not. Angels are always good, but spirits are not always good. So avoid that. Right now, when you still have life, do acts of love. Oh. to the deepest part of the ocean inside yourself. And in the deepest part of the ocean, see as if a tree has caught many, many leaves, and each leaf has caught a head. And each head is shining bright, and it's other people, but it's also you. God is present in everyone and in you also. Om Namo Shiva. Go near that tree-like structure. Each leaf is like another head. All these heads are shining bright, and they are, you know, other people representative, but they also represent the many-headed godliness inside you. You are not one person. You are many-headed godliness inside you, in the deepest part of your heart. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. Bless, become a pure blessing. Go to the root of the tree and see, you become one with the source of godliness in everything and everyone. And all these leaves and heads, which represent other lives, is also you. Om, go deep, and now just Om, feel the vibration of Om. Om. You become an energy of pure love, Om, from your heart, shining bright to everything and everyone. So the first healing that you have to do is filling your own head and your own body with pure golden light radiating from your heart. You want to be a healer for others? First, you have to heal yourself so that your own body, your own universe, which you control as a person while on this planet, is filled with pure golden love. Om. 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 The whole of the universe is energy, and energy is just a vibration. And each vibration has got a frequency, and this frequency, as per the Hindus, and also some parts of science have like acknowledged it, is very close, if not the same as the vibration of Om. So to achieve communion, you change your frequency to that of pure love of Om. Om. Each breathe in very gently. Oh, breathe in. Ma, from your heart, radiate pure love and dissolve. Om. 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 Now, this breathing during meditation is becoming representative of your life. So I want you to go to the root cause of your problems. Be very thankful for whatever gave you the most problem. Even if it is something which is causing you to die. If it is cancer, send gratitude to cancer. If it is the partner who hurt you or something, or loss or something, send gratitude. Be thankful for whatever caused you to be hurt, because that is your true guru, teacher, which is bringing you enlightenment. Otherwise, people can be born with lots of money, good looks, etc., and just in a comfortable way be miserable throughout their life and keep on suffering from ennui. Ennui is a special depression when you have everything and you feel you have nothing. And it's very common, very, very common. Om. So fill your universe of thoughts in the head, of emotions in the heart, of all your sexual energy in the lowest part of your body. Fill your whole universe with golden light radiating from your heart. As you breathe in, why are people unhappy? They do not see the blessing of pain. And they become scared, and everyone wants to take more and give less. And we think that person is really smart. That person made something like, let's say, the WhatsApp ad, and he spent 1 month or 90 days on it, and he made $20 billion. Those three people, let's say. So we think that is so smart. It's good, it's smart, because it's helping humanity communicate. That is there. But we start thinking in different terms, that that person took something and then made so much out of it. So he spent 90 days and then got so much amount of money out of it. And that's smart. No. Everyone is what's in it for me. And how can I get more, including in love, in business, in it. You and me, we are becoming unconditional givers and blessers. So we take in, when we say Om, we take in some energy from the universe. Om, it goes inside us, some amount. And then from our burning heart, we transmute that energy to million, billion times more powerful blessings, and we give more. Om. Shine out much more than you took in with Om. So when you breathe out, you breathe out from the heart, and you breathe out much more longer. You breathe in Om, 100 grams of Om, and million kilograms of happiness you spread around from your heart. Om. 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 As you become a spreader of joy, your own private issues, I do not have this, or I do not have this much enough, or I need this, are dissolved. By focusing on now, all your past drops away. So to go away all your anger. This happened that way. This happened. This should not have happened. Why did this happen? Because we came to the planet for adventures, and this is what was required. This happened and we took it the wrong way. We had asked for this husband or this partner to leave us or cheat us or whatever has happened. And we had asked for this COVID. We had asked for these things. Otherwise, they won't be happy. Everything given or taken is a blessing. Even if it's the job that you lost or something that didn't happen as you would have liked. But then you are not you. You are not this, just, you are much more than this name and face person. When you go to the meditation in your heart, what face did you see? It was all energy. So your name and face are just not so much as coincidental, but something like you went to the parking lot and you got the car, and for different reasons you had asked, oh, I want to be born to this part of family because in my last life I had hated this person, so let that person be my mom in this life. Something like that. And it always, so the universe, which is represented by the deepest part of you, always has got a logic to it. And that logic we call karma. But karma is not an enslavement, it is a freedom. Because we are born on this planet to do acts of love. And we can be in any circumstances of the body, but our mind and our intentions are somewhat under our control. So we can start with meditation by sending love to everything that hurt us and having full gratitude, in fact, falling in love, whatever your problem. If you are dying, fall in love with dying. If you are losing a job, fall in love with losing the job. If you are alone and feel that you fall in love with being alone. Whatever you have, first fall in love, and then it will, things are always changing. It will either not be an issue for you, and then totally, if you want whatever you think that you need more to make others happy, you will find. Ask the universe, not I want this because then I will be happy. It doesn't work out. You can ask that, if I had this thing, then I would be able to serve more. And sometimes businessmen come to me and they start to, I want to make this much amount of money so that I will be able to do this and etc. And it's just a mind game. But you, as truly spiritually divine people who have uncovered your potential to bless others, that is all that enlightenment is. And enlightenment means that your heart can smile. You are not taking anything, even enlightenment, too seriously, and you are free. Free with gratitude for everything that has ever hurt you or can ever hurt you. Free with full amount of gratitude. And do everything that is rational. Like you, if you see some violent, you don't have to be attracted towards it. You move away. You do everything. To get the new job, to get the new relationship, to get it. Do everything. But inside in your heart, be equanimous. Total gratitude for any result that you cannot change. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. And the trick is that you breathe in Om, you breathe out from your heart, and you give more than you took in on the planet, and you are going to be happy. By doing this Om, your inner demons, for lack of any other word, will be resolved. Your pain, fear, anger, the Om energy inside you will remove those things so that you become a pure instrument of energy of spreading love and light and love. Om Namo Shiva. Om in its very basic form is vibration of the infinite. So by focusing on that with your breathing in and out, you get the peace of being in harmony with the universe. Namo Shiva is a request, is a cell phone call like any other prayer. So when you reach out to the infinity, directly, the moment you connect with water, your hands get wet. You get the qualities of whatever you are reaching out for. So since God is infinite love, when you pray with any prayer, it can be our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on heaven as in earth. On this day give us our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass. Lead us from temptation, deliver us from evil. Thine is the power, the glory, the kingdom. And for those who have healing issues, etc., take special note. The mantra that I'm going to be saying is called Mahamrityunjaya, and it will either remove the cause, or you will find power in yourself to surmount it. And it is like, it's think of God of infinity. You can think of Shiva, Ein Sof. You can think of Jesus. He had infinity of love. He went to cross so much amount of body pain for others. Krishna, Buddha, any form. See that presence. Activate it in your heart with your seeing of that image and now. Om Trayambakam Vidamahi Sugandhim Pushti Vardhanam Urvarukme Bandhanan Mrityur Mukshem Amratat. Om Trayambakam Vidamahi Sugandhim Pushti Vardhanam और वो आरुप में बंदना नित्योर मुक्षेम अमृतात् ओम त्र्यंबकम् यजामहे सुगंधिं पुष्टि वदनम् और वो आरुप में बंदना नित्योर मुक्षेम अमृतात् ओम शांति शांति। If you have any question, you can ask or send me by email. We have prayed for the lead, for the person. So that person will also, and you also can learn the Om Trayambakam or just simple Om. Somehow we don't want the same breakfast. We want different breakfasts every day, etc. So all the different prayers, they are the same at the very root. And so are we with everyone on the planet, at the very level, at the deepest level of the heart. There is no time, there is no space. We are all connected. And we bless everything and it comes back to us, healing us. And we start by understanding that happiness is only for those who become cause, instruments of spreading happiness to others. So as long as we are looking for happiness, we can't find it. It's like the hyperbole. But when you say, I am going to be an unconditional source of happiness by spreading for now free energy from your heart. That's what happens when you see the symbol of God in your heart. When you visualize the person associated with it, whether it is Muhammad, whether it is Krishna, whether it is Jesus, whether it is Archangel Michael in your heart or Shiva, then those qualities get triggered and activated inside us. And when the heart is open, because it does not have any anger or fear, then only the heart opens. And that thinking is controlled by us. So by meditation, that is resolved. Our fear and anger leaves, our heart opens up. And then that energy rising from the lower part can blossom and radiate love to others in the process, filling our own body, which we is the universe that we control to some extent. Your love, healing ourselves, healing others with unconditional love. Thank you. Om Tat Sat. Om Tat Sat. Om Tat Sat. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Match it with your breathing. Om Namo Shiva. Om. Taking some amount of energy. Om. Let it go to your heart. Namo. Open your heart. Shiva. Infinite energy. You. Bless out. Om Namo Shiva. Om Namo Shiva. Think of all the people in your life that you had any anger at. And send to them prayer energy right now. Om Namo Shiva. See yourself as being joyous and happy from tomorrow or right now. See the other people as being a joyous and happy. Om Namah Shivaya. Dissolve all your pain, fear, anger. Just spread love from a laughing heart. Om Namah Shivaya.